I'm Greg Poulter. I'm a physician with OrthoIndy, specializing in spine surgery and scoliosis. Today we're going to discuss how to check for scoliosis. When someone comes to see me for a first-time scoliosis evaluation, many times they're referred from both a school nurse or possibly their primary care physician, both who may have identified a potential curve. I recommend that people be aware of scoliosis throughout a child's growth and development, but recommend that they start looking more closely around age 10 or 11, as that is when many of these curves become visible. The process to check for scoliosis is the same for children and adults, although it can differ as far as what we see. So although the process is the same, what we find for a patient may differ very based on their age. The first thing that we do when we're looking for scoliosis is to actually look at the spine. And whether it be someone who has their shirt off or is wearing clothing that's tight enough for us to see the contours, we're looking to see if the spine is straight and symmetric. If there are any obvious curves here, obviously we're concerned about a possible scoliosis. The next thing that we do is check for symmetry. And we start with the hips, and simply by touching the sides of the hips, you can feel the top of the pelvic brim. And if the hips are level, that's a sign of a straight spine. And then we next look for the shoulders to be level as well. If there's asymmetry in the hips or in the shoulders, that can be the sign of something occurring, whether it be a leg length discrepancy or another etiology. Scoliosis is one of the things that may contribute to either one hip or one shoulder being higher. And the last thing we look for is symmetry in the contour of the spine. So we ask our patients to bring their hands together and to roll their spines forward. And what we're looking for is whether or not there's rotation through the spine. And that would show up as either one shoulder blade being higher than another, or of a prominence of the muscles on one side of the low back or the other. Asymmetry here can be a sign of rotation, and rotation often goes hand in hand with scoliosis and can raise the suspicion of there being an underlying curve. To schedule an appointment with us, you can visit us at our OrthoIndy website. If you'd like to learn more about this or other conditions, you can always subscribe to our YouTube channel.